Dude, did that one actually work?
Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we are working on one of the most fun videos I have ever done. We are making a Rube Goldberg Home Alone inspired chain reaction machine, whatever you want to call it. The Home Alone movies are super near and dear to my heart, so I'm really excited to be doing this project this holiday season. I'm taking on this project in partnership with Snapmaker, who are currently running their Home Alone Video Maker Contest. For the challenge, you have to make your own Rube Goldberg, trap, toy, gizmo, etc., upload the video, and you have a chance at winning some really awesome prizes and some cash money. So thank you so much to Snapmaker for sponsoring this video. I think this is going to be a ton of fun. I'm gonna be doing this whole project using the Snapmaker Artisan. This is a 3-in-1 machine, so it's a 3D printer, a CNC machine, and a laser engraver. Hey, Scout's eating my Christmas tree.
What are you up to, buddy? What are you doing?
I already have it assembled. It's sitting right over there and I love it a lot so far. So let's go ahead and jump right in.
So for those of you who aren't familiar with what a Rube Goldberg machine is, it's basically a machine that accomplishes a very simple task, but does it in a very complicated kind of roundabout way. So in our context, it's just a really cool challenge to flex your engineering skills, go back to simple machine basics. So as you can see, I've done a lot of kind of sketches and planning for this, and this is not the final plan. I've done some minor revisions to this since. And the overall machine that I have planned out is about 8 to 10 steps long, depending on how you want to break it up. It incorporates a lot of fun things, a lot of Christmas Easter eggs. And for a lot of these different steps, I'm going to be using the different functions of the Artisan machine. So I'm really excited to see what it can do and to incorporate it as much as I can.
Okay, so this is the machine itself. It's actually really big, but a lot of the size is just due to the enclosure, which I have set up for noise reduction, dust control, and also odor and smoke control when using the laser engraving function. And also, it's worth noting again, this is a 3-in-1 machine. So technically, if you got this machine, you wouldn't need a separate space for a laser engraver, a CNC machine, and a 3D printer. This machine does it all. Inside the door, once you open it up, is the printer itself. This rail system is really different from every other bedslinger style 3D printer I've ever seen before, and so far it feels really sturdy and secure. As you can see, I have the 3D printing module on the tool head right now, but this is super easily switched to the CNC and laser functions, and I'll show you how to do that in a bit. I'm using Snapmaker's own software, Snapmaker Luban, and this is what it looks like when you open up the application. You have your choice of tool head up here, as well as your workspace where you can send the files to the machine over Wi-Fi. We're starting with the 3D printing, so let's open that up. I actually really like this interface. It's similar to a lot of other slicers. You select your machine up here, and then you can select the material for each nozzle. By the way, this is a dual extruder head that I'm using, so you can use two different materials or colors at once, and it saves a lot of time. Back on the main screen, you have your basic settings, as well as the more advanced settings if you click in here. So I'm going to start with these pulleys. I just modeled these in Fusion 360, and I'm going to need a few of these printed for this project. And by the way, this is the control hub. All of the cords from the machine's separate parts all interface here, where you can start prints, adjust settings, switch between the tool heads, etc.
Okay, so these look really great, honestly. You can see here where it was not supported. I did not enable supports on these just because I wanted to see what this machine was capable of in terms of overhangs. With that in mind, let's get to printing our next pieces. Okay, so everything we've done so far is pretty familiar territory 3D printing wise, but now it's time to work with the CNC function of the machine. There's one part of my Rube Goldberg that is going to require marbles rolling down a track. And I really want there to be divots along the track so that the marbles fall into it as they roll down and only one marble makes it to the end and can trigger the next step of the machine. And I know that probably doesn't make any sense right now, but you're gonna see what I mean in a second. And then the other thing I wanna do with the CNC machine is actually make a cool little sign at the end of the Rube Goldberg machine. It's just gonna say Snapmaker X Universe of Emily or something like that. I'm really excited, so let me show you guys real quick how we convert the machine from a 3D printer to a CNC machine.
So to switch the machine's function, the first thing we're gonna do is just unlock the base plate. Unplug the cable in the rear and remove it. and then we just replace it with the CNC base plate and lock it into place. Next, unlock the tool head, slide it off, unplug the cable, and then repeat those steps in reverse order for the CNC tool head. So once again, in Snapmaker Luban, it's really easy to import vector images or create your own with the drawing tools inside the workspace. So I'm just importing the Snapmaker logo and sizing it how I want it to look. And then after setting the target depth, material type, and speeds, we are ready to send this over to the artisan. I'm using the flat end mill for this design, but the machine comes with a bunch of different types of mills. All you do is insert the bit into the screw and then thread it onto the tool head itself. Then we just let the machine do its thing. Alright, the logo sign is done and I'm super impressed by how clean this came out. I love it. Now let's just repeat that with our marble rail. And now you can see that I've just added the sides with some liquid nails, and I think this is gonna work great.
One of the parts of this machine that I'm the most excited about is my custom Plinko board. I don't know where this idea came from, but I really have been fixated on making a Plinko board as part of this whole chain reaction setup. This is the board I'm gonna be using behind me, and the plan is to have a bunch of different elements going on here. To make the board a little bit more customized, I'm going to be using the laser engraving function on the machine to add some details.
Once again in Luban, this should be a very familiar process by now. Import your vector, size it, and set your material type, whether you want it to cut or engrave, and for this we are engraving, and send it over to the machine. I'm placing the wood piece I want to engrave inside the machine, closing the door, and then letting it do its thing. Make sure to have the exhaust going either out the window or into an air purifier. I have mine set up with the Snapmaker air purifier. When using laser tools, I also recommend keeping a fire extinguisher handy in case of emergencies. I also engraved a few wooden dominoes of different sizes and cut thin wood pieces to make these fun pinwheels for the Plinko board. Now that everything is made, it's time to put all the pieces together and set the machine up to actually run.
Okay, so it's the next morning now. I finished assembling the whole machine late last night. So that means today I get to film it. And it is the perfect day for filming right now. It snowed last night. Didn't hit the string.
This was, of course, not as easy or smooth as I thought it was gonna be, but many, many, many adjustments and attempts later, we finally got the machine to run from start to finish.
Thank you guys so much for watching this video and for joining me on this maker challenge. This was really difficult, I'm not gonna lie, but I had a lot of fun. I have not done a Rube Goldberg machine type project since I was in grade school. Thank you again to Snapmaker for sponsoring this video and for providing the Snapmaker Artisan, which made this whole project possible. Like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.